I'm going to show you an uptime monitor that does more than just check if a site is live or not. And I do think that it's better than Better Uptime, because I do have Better Uptime and I think that this does more than that. One of the key features of Uptimia, what it does, it lets you check if a site is working correctly based on steps. What do I mean by that? Let's just say that you have a WooCommerce site or a SaaS. You want to make sure that someone can go to the site, go into the checkout page, go to the store, etc., and make sure that those steps work correctly. That's something that other uptime monitors don't do. So this ensures us that it's not just about checking if a site is live, it's checking if it's working correctly. And it has a bunch of other features that I'm going to show you on this video. Okay, so what I'm talking about is called Uptimia. And let me show you the key features first before we actually jump into the deal. So there's four key features of Uptimia. First of all is the uptime monitor. Yes, this will do what other uptime monitors do. And if you're just looking to making sure that a site is live or not, then you don't need this. But it does everything that the other ones do, like HTTPS, the DNS, POP3, and all of those. This one actually checks the speed monitor. That's something that not many do, and you get it included on this deal. So you can check if the site is working correctly, if the speed load is doing fine, or if it's going lower, and we'll get alerted if it's lower. And then there's a transaction monitoring. This is where I think it stands out, and this is one of the reasons I'm going to switch some of my sites to Uptimia, is because I can make sure that the site is working correctly based on steps. So I'm making sure that if they can go into the form, they can fill out the form and it's working correctly. Or they can go to the sign up page and do this and that, etc. And it's gonna work correctly based on those steps. If not, it's going to alert me and I'm going to check it. And then we get the real user monitor, which is actually like a monitor also. And I'll show you how that works in a bit. Now, let me show you the deal that's going on right now, which is on a lifetime deal that you might want to take advantage of it. That means you pay once and use it forever. And it starts off at $69, which is, well, not a lot, because if you pay month to month another service, well, this is really cheap in that kind of meaning, all right? So let me show you what that gets you with the $69 deal. So you get access to 50 uptime checks, 5 users, 750,000 total page views per month, 75 SMS messages. These only work for US and Canada numbers, so be aware of that. If you're not there, you can still use the service, but you're not gonna get the SMS. You will get the email notifications. Or if you connect Twilio, which is available with this, well, you can pay for Twilio and get those messages. 1 minute testing interval, 5 advanced checks, and 5 real user monitor websites. Now, if you need more advanced checks, a shorter interval checking, I do consider that you need to jump into license tier 2 or license tier 3, which gives you more sites and more uptime checks, etc. All right, now let's jump into my uptime monitor. Well, actually my Uptimia site. I've added 2 sites just for testing and just to show you the power of this. And I added one of my sites, which is Kipler.mx, and I've added a link shortener that I use. This is not my site, but I want to make sure that it's actually working. So if it goes down, I know that my links are gonna go down. So that's why I'm actually monitoring that, okay? So you're gonna get the up stats here for the average ability, active incidents, the pause incidents in the last 8 days, etc., all that good stuff. If I need to add a new monitor, I can go ahead and click here. And this is where we're going to get the options for any type of monitor that we want to create here. So for example, if I just want to check the web, I'll go ahead and do that there. If I need to check the network, like TCP, the ping, the DNS, the UDP, I select this. If I want to check the email, SMTP or POP3 to make sure that the emails are working correctly, well, I can select that. SSL monitoring, speed monitoring. So if I want to know if the site is speedy or not, or if it has a lower speed and I will get alerted. And then we get the real user monitor. This is something that I want to jump into, real user and transaction monitoring, because these are the interesting ones. So for example, I'll just give this name a test site and I'll just put something like another site that I have. There we go. I won't add bulk because I don't want to add another one. Do I want to get an outage alert? Yes. A performance alert? Yes. Drop in traffic alert. So let's just say that you have constant traffic on that site and for any sudden reason you get less traffic, well, you're going to get alerted, okay? JavaScript error alerting, so you can do that there, and you can set up the thresholds and the minutes here available. Visitor transaction satisfactoriness settings, so you can set that there for speeds and all of that. Who do you want to alert? Me, in this case. You can add more people in the settings and we'll keep it like that, but I can add more people in case you are doing this for a business. If you want to alert someone else, that's possible. So I can just go ahead and create this monitor and boom, it's gonna start doing it. Now, if you want to check out, for example, like the drop in visitors, you'd have to add the script to it. So just be aware of that. You get the incident log, you get the pages, JavaScript errors, geographic from where they're visiting, the browsers and the devices type. Again, if you're using the script like you have to do it right here, okay? So that's one of the ones that you can create. The next one is a transaction monitor. This is the one I really think stands out, and this could be super useful for specific cases. So it's added by default here. Website name, again, test, and I'll add the same site. I hope it lets me do it. So I'm going to load this site. Be aware that if you have a firewall, you need to give them access to this IP so they start doing the checkups. But what it's going to do, it's going to load the page so I can add the next steps. There we go, it just loaded it. And I can add the steps to this. What do I want to check that's working correctly? Like what steps have to happen in order for me to get alerted in case they're not working? So I can do, for example, click on an element, fill with text, check, uncheck, select the radio button, select the drop-down menu, etc. And you can just go ahead and do that there. For example, if I do click, it's gonna give me all the options of the sections where I can click on. So let's just say that that's going to be the second step. I can add another command to this. I can add another step to here, do another thing, for example, fill, check, etc. I won't go in depth into this, but you get the idea. It's checking if these steps work correctly, and if not, I get alerted. And then I'll jump in and go to fix it or tell the developer to go check it out. Notification settings, the alerting, and all that is the same. I think this is one of the key features of transaction monitoring. I think this is the best Uptimia feature that it has, all right? Now, one of the things that I think Better Uptime Monitor is better than Uptimia is their escalation of like alerting. That's something that they need to work on in Uptimia. What do I mean that? Let me show you Better Uptime really quickly. Now, Better Uptime, what it has is the escalation policies, which is going to alert different type of people depending on the time it's been down or different type of situations. So if a site has been down more than 24 hours, then alert the next person or alert the developer, etc. And I think that's something that Uptimia needs to add in order to compete with Better Uptime in that sense. I like that part of features of the Better Uptime than Uptimia. Then we have the reporting. So if you need to create reports, it's available here, right? So just go ahead and update settings and So if you need to create reports, we can go ahead and do so here. So you go into reports, we have my contacts, the users that you can add here, the team members, the integrations. So it's available to integrate with Webhook, which Webhook would give you access to anything that you want to connect to, like Public Connect, Zapier, Integromat, etc. You got integrations with WhatsApp, Slack, Microsoft Teams, Twilio in case you need to send SMS messages to someone else, or if the SMS messages that are included in the package are not enough, then you can switch to Twilio with this, all right? Public status page. So if you need to create a public status page, so you can share this. If you have a SaaS, I'll give you one that I just created for demo purposes. So if you have a SaaS and you want to give them access to a link on the bottom, the footer, to let them know if the site is up or down or if there's a maintenance scheduled or whatever, you have a page dedicated for that with this. And yes, they do have custom domain available, so you can add yours there. The scheduled reports, if you need to create a scheduled report to receive these, I don't know, every week, every month, etc., that is possible there. Send custom reports, you can do so here. You can select the pages that you want to send the custom reports with or not, you can select them there, and you got all of that there. The branding there, if you want to create that for the reports, you can create a new theme, you can change the logo, the name, some colors, etc., and you can create the theme with that, okay? And last but not least, we have the settings where you can set your maintenance window in case you want to create one of these sections. So you can set the name for it and the frequency of this, the duration, show status on page for that maintenance window. You can do all by group, individual monitors, etc. All of that you can be done with Uptimia. But basically you get all the information here on the main dashboard for activity incidents once they happen, the incident log, the monitoring log, etc. But that is the Uptimia deal. Like I mentioned before, I mean, if you're just looking for a way to know if a site is up, if it's live or not, then you can use any monitor that you want to use. So if you have something that you have already, there's no need to buy this. But if you're looking for speed tests, transactions, monitor, then yes, this is something to consider. Especially if you have a SaaS or an e-commerce store, you do want to make sure that the steps that a user might take work correctly. Because basically, you just don't want to know if a site is live. You want to know if it's working correctly. But there you go. That is Uptimia. If you want to grab the deals going on, there will be a link in the description, which is an affiliate link. So if you buy through it, it helps me out with a small commission. I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next videos.